MMA Inside the Cage, presented by Elevation Training Mask.
Welcome back to MMA Inside the Cage. It's second round time. Now, there's no doubt that women's MMA is at an all-time high with the success of Invicta and the inclusion into the UFC. That's why we have a top 10 women's fighters that we think can move the needle and really make some money, Casey. And you have to have that to keep the sport growing.
Well, exactly. Just like we see in men's competition, the most successful fighters are those that bring the total package to the table. That means not only having the skill and athleticism to keep winning fights, but it's also having that it factor that keeps the fans interested in coming back for more. So here are our top 10 of the sport's leading ladies that we feel have it all.
Now, coming in at number 10, we have a rising Australian talent that we know very well from the AFC, Lana the Black Mamba Kate.
Now, this is a fighter that we've seen undergo a stylistic metamorphosis over the last year. Originally regarded primarily as a kickboxer, Lana Kate has recently taken her wrestling and jiu-jitsu skills to new heights, bringing her that round 3 TKO victory last May at AFC 5. Now, while at first glance, Lana's exotic look seems to fit in nicely with the cast of Mad Max, this devoted mother carries herself with true class and respect of a professional.
At number 9, we saw her last weekend in a war with Tisha Torres, the future Mrs. Pat Barry, I'm sure, Thug Rose Namajunas. What makes her so special?
Well, two things. She knows how to fight, and she knows how to talk. She is immensely entertaining, and her high-profile relationship with Pat Barry just adds to that allure. This is a fighter that plays to win and will try anything it takes to get the job done, as was evident with her big flying armbar win at Invicta 5.
No doubt about it.
Now, coming in at number 8 is KSW's pride and joy, Karolina Kowalkiewicz.
Well, I'll tell you what, Case. She's 3-0. She's got some good finishes, and she's really not too bad to look at. I mean, that does really help with that allure. I see her becoming that female Mamed or Blachowicz, a product of that KSW promotional machine.
And in at number 7, we head to the XFC. We're talking about Stephanie Snowflake Egging.
Tell you what, Case, she's 3-1. She's won her last two fights. She's just a real talented fighter, not to mention she does kind of have that swagger, and she's really at the forefront of the WMMA division for the XFC. You'll see her at XFC 25 in Albuquerque going for the title. Now, at number 6, we go to the UFC. How about Liz Carmouche? Now, she lost to Ronda Rousey, but she is a huge fan following.
Absolutely. Carmouche made history as not only one of the first two women to ever compete in the UFC, but she did this while vying for the very first UFC Women's Championship. And of course, she made history by being the first openly homosexual fighter to ever compete in the UFC as well. This lady opened a lot of doors in the sport that night and is someone that the world will continue to have their eye on.
And at number 5, Casey, Bellator's new centerpiece, the Bulldog, Felice Herrig.
Now, at first glance, you may suspect that Felice Herrig got where she's at from her look alone, but that's until you see her fight. This prodigy of MMA legends Jeff and Pat Curran brings a 9-4 record to the table and is one of the sport's most well-rounded competitors. With a recent win over Heather Clark at Bellator 94, Herrig's career appears to be on the rise with no end in sight. Now, in at number 4 is Invicta's Australian wild child, Rowdy Beck Hyatt.
Beck Hyatt has the look, the attitude, and the skills to back it up. She's coming off a couple of tough losses, but she's still one of the most recognizable female fighters in the world today, and she loves being there with Invicta.
Now, how about number 3, Misha Cupcake Tate?
Now, they used to call her Takedown as well. I'll tell you what, Misha Tate has lost a little steam, but you cannot deny her track record. Former Strikeforce champion, and could really be the best wrestler in all of women's MMA. Oh, and did you see the ESPN body issue, Casey? I know you did. Now, we're at number 2 and number 1. There's really no surprise here. Number 2, the unstoppable Chris Cyborg Justino, Invicta featherweight champ.
She isn't a big talker and she doesn't tie her hair in pigtails, but Chris Cyborg is the most physically imposing presence that women's mixed martial arts has ever witnessed. She has already used her aggressive blend of striking, wrestling, and grappling skills to secure both the Strikeforce and Invicta world titles, and she just keeps getting better. Considered by many to be the most dangerous woman on the planet, Cyborg brings qualities to the cage never before seen in women's MMA.
And at number 1, no surprise here, Casey, she's got WMMA on her back right now. The outspoken, undefeated, bantamweight champion of the UFC, Rowdy Ronda Rousey.
I don't believe there has ever been another fighter, man or woman, that has made the stir that Ronda Rousey has. When this judo Olympian stepped onto the scene, she decimated everyone in her path, all by submission, all in round 1. It was that, combined by Rousey's tremendous charisma and verbiage, that established her as the face of women's MMA, setting her up for that monumental UFC world title victory in the main event of UFC 157, and it doesn't stop there. Ronda Rousey prepares to make history again as one of the coaches of Tough 18.
Oh man, I'll tell you what, these ladies are really moving the needle, and these are the ones that are going to keep WMMA going. Some honorable mentions, Zola Gurgel, Alexis Davis, Cast Iron Courtney Casey, and just the rest of all the ladies just paving the way here for the sport. Now, coming up in the third round, we're going to take a look at Hip Show as they get ready for season number 3.